Hi there. Today I want to let know the Prime Minister of Pakistan, and anytime anybody meets the Prime Minister of Pakistan, that there is only one way Pakistan can grow and become a strong nation and really take care of the citizens of their country if they want peace with India, because they cannot defeat India in any field, in any area of calling. They have fought several wars, but they have been devastated, they have been ruined and destroyed, they have been broken to pieces. But these people do not understand the language of peace. Several times they will send the terrorist, which is created in their own land, and trying to kill millions of the Indians innocent. So many times they have done it. And India is very weak to retaliate. It will give few people, 10, 20, either by surgical strike or by sending some kind of planes and killing some of the terrorists hiding in the hub of the forest. But I let them know the Pakistani who really hates Indians, love is the way. If you love India and the Indian citizens, they are your brothers and sisters, because we were together for hundreds of years. But because of the jinnas, selfishness and greed, and Nehru's idiotic attitude to become the head of the states, the Prime Minister of India, and Jinnah, the President of Pakistan, they really made a deal, and Gandhi supported them, and India was divided into two parts. But the division was totally illogical, irrational. If they were divided on the basis of religion, then why India has more than 40 crores of Muslims? They are our sisters and brothers, we love them. But I don't know the logic why it was divided on the basis of religion, and still India is the dominant, the second largest Muslim population on this planet Earth after Indonesia. We should not think about Hindu and Muslims, we should think about sisters and brothers, and we should live in harmony, that I'm doing. But the Pakistani heads of the state always fight wars, just for lame excuses. They have a lot of problems, and just divert the attention of the citizens of Pakistan, they keep on waging wars. A new technique they have adopted to create the terrorists. This is the largest place on the planet Earth where terrorists are created and exported to different countries. I request Imran Khan, peace is our mutual interest. I am the citizen of the world, not only belonging to India or Pakistan, but a citizen of the world, want peace all over the world. Peace is only our way. Let's come together. We have no problem. There is no problem at all. Just our mind has problems. And let those problems go away and live in peace. And one suggestion for Narendra Modi also. If Imran Khan and his successor and predecessors never knew the value of peace, then we are fighting a small wars. We are defeating Pakistan several times. They are sending a lot of terrorists. We are killing them at the borders. Every time they do that, they are really creating hell of problems. Then Imran Khan, listen. And Narendra Modi, listen. Don't fight like a dog. The dog's war, the dog fight. War should be like Mahabharata, Kaurava and Pandava war, and devastated by Pandava to the Kauravas. That kind of war you fought. So that ultimately there will be no Pakistan, and there will be no war, and there will be no terrorists coming from that land. But the Pakistan should learn it, that you will be destroyed if somebody like me, Yogi Virendra Yogi, request you several times, try to embrace you, try to tell you that peace is our way, happiness is our way. Sisters and brothers of Pakistan and India, we want to live together in peace. But you don't want peace, you want bloodshed. I don't know what is the reason that you only want bloodshed. Killing our soldiers, killing our sisters and brothers at the borders, sending those terrorists in every parts of the India. Then I tell you, Narendra Modi is a very noble man. He really fears what the world fraternity will talk about him. Probably he's thinking to get a Nobel Peace Prize, but I tell you, Peace Prize is not the goal of any great citizen of India. The goal of India and the goal of the any great citizen of India is to have peaceful neighbors. And if you don't know how to make peace, then war is only the solution. And war, not by lathi, bana, farsa, talwar, guleti, and bullets. War by devastation. Few bombs here and there in Pakistan, and Pakistan is no more. Let the bomb come to India also. Let the bomb come to India also. One day we will all die, but our prodigy, our generation will live in peace. Every evils and devils who really attack Indian borders every time, finish that land. Let their fraternity, the world's fraternity, say, why you have a nuclear war? India should attack by nuclear weapons because they want peace and you want war. How long we can fight with bullet, lathi, farsa and bana? Nuclear war. I am ready to die first. I am the retired general. I don't like to leave seeing our sisters and brothers innocent either in Pakistan or India die by your terrorists. So Imran Khan, listen, and Narendra Modi, listen. Send them a clear-cut message. We want peace. You come, negotiate, and peace for thousands of years so that sisters and brothers of Pakistan and India can live in harmony, in cooperation. But if you don't want peace, then be ready for war. Be ready, man! Be ready. And fight till finish. There will be no Imran Khan for another thousands of years to unnecessarily quarrel with India. Finish that. There will be few Indians left over because India has 1.5 billion people. Pakistan has something like a fraction of that. Finish that. Finish that. And anybody in India also want to support Pakistan, finish them also. We want peaceful citizens, not only in India and Pakistan, but all over the world. And there are some millions of good citizens in Pakistan also. Everyone has to learn the value of peace and learn to live in perfect harmony and peace. Peace is the way of living life happily. We are all for a very short time on this planet Earth. Nobody is going to live here. Billions, yes, nobody can live. The Earth is a place where birth and death is a cycle. I wish you best of luck, Imran Khan and Narendra Modi. Come to negotiation table and the world fraternity, the heads of the state, make India and Pakistan live in peace and Israel and Philistine live in peace, and the Chinese dictator, the monsters who is killing everyone by coronavirus, he should also be taught lesson. Unite the democratic forces of the world. Attack Chinese Xi Jinping. Finish him off. Not only human beings are being killed by the most dangerous pandemic, our creatures are also being killed. Birds, fish and mud plants are also affected by coronavirus. This demon, he should be taught a lesson. He don't know what is peace. He has accumulated money by business, trillions of dollars. And the money has come from different lands of this planet Earth. Unite! Fight till finish. Or live in peace. Two options, war or peace. Thank you.